Hello learners, welcoming you all. In this video I am going to start exercise 2.3. actually I am not going to start exercise 2.3. before that I want to explain you about growth and depreciation. So let's see what I have tried here to explain. In exercise 2.3, the sums are based on these two topics, growth and depreciation. So first of all, I am preparing video on topic growth only, and my next video will be on depreciation. So what is growth? You all knew what is the meaning of growth. So I have explained it by giving you two examples. In example 1, I have mentioned here a name, Mr. XYZ. He kept his money, about 1 lakh rupees, in a bank, and after 5 years he got back 1,02,000 rupees. It means you can see there is a growth in his money. He kept only 1 lakh rupees but he got back 1,02,000. So this 2,000 is growth in his money. So money has grown from 1 lakh to 1,02,000 rupees. In previous exercises we have learned that this money was named as principal and this is named as amount. Now in second example, see what I'm going to show you. There was a plot of land which Mr. XYZ wanted to buy. Initially that plot of land was priced at rupees 1 lakh. This was 5 years ago. Presently the price of that same plot is rupees 1,02,000. Okay, this was not 10,000, this was 1,02,000, right? So what was the previous cost of the land? That was 1 lakh, and that is 5 years ago. And now after 5 years, what is the cost of the land? That is 1,02,000. It means again we can see the growth of money. We saw just like money can grow in a given span of time, even the value of land or any other commodity or entity can grow, any property, any other property. So in both examples we saw that the value of land as well as the money grew from 1 lakh to rupees 1,02,000 after 5 years. Here in first example I have shown you with the help of previous exercises which you have solved about compound interest, that principal became amount when compounded annually or half yearly or quarterly at the given rate and for a fixed timing. Similarly we are going to learn about this thing when you will see the growth in the value of the land or any property. So what we have learned previously, how we have solved sums based on amount and principal, we have used this formula, A is equals to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. With the help of this formula we can find the amount when time and rate is given. That's why I have shown it with the help of the formula. Here we are applying above formula in order to get final value, that is amount after T years at the rate of R percent. Now what formula do we apply if we have to find out the final value of the land or any other property after T years with growth rate? This formula will be similar formula of amount. In place of P, that is principal, we will take V0, and for amount we will write V. What we will write V. So what is V0? V0 will be the initial value of the land. What is V? V will the final value of the land or any property whose price increased. T will be time and rate will be growth rate. R will be growth rate. So what is the formula? That will be V is equals to V0 into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. Here I have shown that R is growth rate. Okay, so what we'll do here, we can compare it. For amount we are writing A is equals to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. For for growth, we will write V is equals to V0 within bracket 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. Here I want to mention about depreciation also. If there is fall in rate of any item, maybe any vehicle, any car, or any item, any entity, there is change in sign only. What will be that formula? That formula will be V is equals to V0 within bracket 1 minus R by 100 to the power T, when you will see there is no growth, there is fall in rate. Okay, that I will explain you in my next video. But for now, we are learning about growth only. Okay, so you just compare it. So when you will writing the formula, you just think that what was the previous value, that will be P here. But for growth, we will write V0 in place. That is the final, when what is the final amount for that, we are using V. So almost similar formula you can see here. So at last we can say that for getting amount, if we knew P, this will the formula A is equals to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. For growth, not for depreciation, for growth, if we knew that any item cost was less, after a few years its rate was increased, so we can use this formula to get the value of, to get final value. And what will the formula? This will be V is equals to V0 within bracket 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. Here again I'm explaining you, if there is growth, if there is increase in rate after a few years, if you will see there is fall in rate, then we will learn about depreciation, and there is change only here in minus sign, plus will become minus sign. That I will explain in my next video. So now I have used an example also so that I can explain the use of this formula. Population of a city at present is 5 lakh and it is growing at the rate of 10%. So find the population of the city after 3 years. What I have written here, V0, you may write that initial population of the city is equals to V0, that is equals to 5 lakh, T is 3 years, growth rate R is 10%. Therefore, population of the city after 3 years is equals to V is equals to question mark. So you may write that statement also, okay? I will write in my next videos when I will start solving the sum of exercise 2.3. So we are putting the value V is equals to V0 within bracket 1 plus R by 100 to the power T. In place of V0, we have written 5 lakh, that is the present population of that city. 1 plus growth rate is 10 by 100. On after how many years we have to find out? This is 3 years. So I have done the calculation, 0 cancelled, then LCM. 10 is there, 5 lakh into 11 into 11 into 11, 10. So after calculation we reached here, that is 6,25,500. At last end it with the statement because this is a word problem. So we will write population of that city will be 6,25,500 after 3 years. And here this video is over. Please see next video for depreciation and for sums based on this one. Thank you everyone.